Welcome to Conversations Live. For more than a decade, we've brought you the best in books, entertainment, celebrity interviews, and current events. When the movers and shakers of the world have something to say to you, they say it to us first. Now celebrating 17 years of broadcasting success, here's your host, Cyrus Webb.
And welcome back, everyone, to Conversations Live. I'm your host, Cyrus Webb. Glad you all could join us once again, both for our radio audience and those tuning in online. We're glad you all could be with us as well. We're excited to welcome recording artist Bella Kaye to our program today to talk to us not only about her love of music, but also what it's been like for her to do what she loves when it comes to music and to share that with all of you. She's celebrating a new project now called Empty Promises. We'll talk to you guys about that, but also let you know how to stay connected with Bella and all the great things that are coming up for her. Bella, hello to you, and welcome to the program.
Hi, thank you for having me. I'm excited to talk to you today.
Yeah, well, look, the pleasure is definitely all mine. Well, look, you know, thanks to artists like you, Bella, 2020 has been a little bit better because we've had new music from you. You know, we've had things to be able to look forward to. What has it been like for you, Bella, to see the response to Empty Promises?
Oh, you know, it's been so great. The response has been really positive, and I'm really grateful for it all. I've gotten DMs how this song can really touch someone else, and actually someone DM'd me saying that it made them cry, and I never want to make anyone cry, but I mean, it's a great feeling to know that my music has touched someone else, and I think it's really cool to be able to start off something that helped me cope with my own situation and then see it connect with somebody else. I think that's a really great feeling.
Yeah. And what I noticed when I was prepping for this segment, Bella, and for those who are not staying connected with you, Bella's website is simply her name, bellakaye.com, and it's Kaye with an E on the end. One thing that we're able to learn is not only your love of music, but also your love of being able to share that music with your fans. There's some great video there with you performing. I mean, what is it like for you, Bella, to be able to be in front of a crowd and to be able to see the way that they're responding to the music live?
I think it's so great. I mean, it's such an exciting and exhilarating experience. I love performing live, and I think to feel the audience's energy, it really brings everything to life. And, you know, I'll see people in the crowd who know the song, and they're singing along and dancing, and it makes me feel really great. And I think music is something that brings people together and provides a lot of joy in life, and I think it's always so great seeing that when I perform.
Have you always known that you wanted to perform, Bella? Is that something that's always kind of been a part of your life?
Yes, it definitely has. Since I was very young, I've always loved to perform. My favorite thing used to be putting on shows for my family. I would just walk around the house singing, love doing that. And then early on, my mom recognized my interest and got me involved with musical theater and the children's choir. And I remember every time at my school when there is a performance when I was young, I'd be so excited to do it. And yeah, I've always definitely known that this is something that I've loved to do. Music has just been in my blood.
Yeah. And what I thought was really interesting, Bella, was also your love of storytelling. I mean, even going back to your first EP, right? I mean, when we look at Reflections, you know, touching on the topics that I think all of us kind of relate to, do you kind of see yourself as a musical storyteller?
Yeah, definitely. A big inspiration of mine is Taylor Swift, and I really admire her storytelling. So I think when I started writing songs, that was definitely something that I, you know, was inspired by. And whenever I write music, I like to use this analogy. I take an inspiration from my life, and it starts as a seed, and then I flourish the seed into a flower when I write the song and, you know, make the story more. And I think storytelling is really important because I think in music that it helps people connect a lot.
Totally agree with that, and we can definitely see that in your music, Bella. For those who are just tuning in, either on the radio side or online, you're listening to Conversations Live. We're excited to welcome recording artist Bella Kaye to our program today. Bella's celebrating not only a new project called Empty Promises, but also talking with us about the musical journey. And that leads us right into Empty Promises, because I mentioned to you before we went on here, Bella, I had a chance, of course, to watch a part of the lyric video that you did for the song. And it's very powerful. Of course, we can tell it's about relationships, but I also think there's a big empowerment in that. Is that one of the things that you hope, especially with your female audience, they realize the importance of knowing, you know, when to be able to say bye, when to be able to let go, and not to hold on to things that don't mean them well?
Yeah, of course. I think goodbyes are really challenging, and especially when you've invested so much in a certain thing, it's hard to let go, and it's hard to accept the truth when you've been hurt by it a lot. And I think there's definitely that layer in the song that even though it's hard, you have to do what's right. And I hope that if someone is experiencing something hard, they can go to that and know that it's okay that you're facing that, but there are ways to get through it, and in the end, you'll be better.
Yeah. Has it been an easy thing for you, Bella, to see yourself as an example for others as to what they can do when it comes to pursuing their own career, their own goals and dreams?
I think that, yeah, I mean, I would love to inspire people to chase their own dreams. I think that's really important. I really believe that it's really important to be vulnerable and speak from your heart, and that's always something that I try to stay true to myself and try to encourage through my music and just, you know, what I stand for, and I think being authentic is super important.
Yeah, I think it definitely comes through for sure, Bella. The other thing I want to talk to you about before we let you go is about social media. I'm following you on Instagram like a lot of other people are. I mean, talk to us about that. We mentioned earlier about your performing in front of a live group, right? But what has it been like for you now to have fans around the world who are able to stay connected with you online?
Yeah, I think that's so amazing. I mean, I think social media is so powerful, and it's such an important tool to connect with people, and I think it's super cool. I mean, I'll get DMs from people from, like, India or different countries, Europe, and I think that's so cool to have been able for somebody in that country to listen to my music and then to reach out to me and to follow me on my journey. I think it's just such a great way to stay connected with people.
Yeah, well, I know they enjoy staying connected with you. I can tell from the comments that you really, really do not only entertain, but you also are able to inspire as well. Bella, what advice would you give to other people out there? I mean, this has been a very weird year for a lot of people, but what advice would you give them about not giving up on the dream and to keep moving forward, even if, you know, there is a time where things aren't moving the way they'd like? What advice would you give them about just keep going?
I think, yes, I would definitely say that it's hard, and you'll face roadblocks, and you'll have self-doubt, and et cetera. But I think it's really important for you to remember why you love to do it and to know to not compare yourself and to not let other people's opinions get in the way. And I know that's a lot easier said than done, and I struggle with that too, but I think that's super important, staying true to yourself and speaking from your heart. And if you do that, it'll be good, and I would just advise you to keep on going and not let your challenges end it, pretty much. Not let you give up.
Yeah, I totally agree. Great advice. Again, everyone, Bella Kaye has been our guest. Make sure you guys get the new single, Empty Promises, as well as, of course, stay connected with her through her website, BellaKaye.com. Where else would you like for them to be able to follow you, Bella?
So you can follow me on my Instagram, which is I'm Bella Kaye. And like you said, the K is spelled K-A-Y-E. And you can also find all my music under all stream platforms under the name Bella Kaye.
All right. Well, Bella, congratulations to you. Thank you so much for the time. I really appreciate it. And looking forward to having you back on the program again.
Yeah, thank you. It was great talking to you.
Oh, same here. And we thank your audience for tuning in to another great segment of Conversations Live.